December 16th.
I skip.
Again, 35 degrees. Woke up.
Beach warmer.
Supposed to be 2 degrees warmer today. Wow. Reminds me of that Beatles song. You know, woke up in the morning, froze my ass to death.
What?
No, that's the wrong song. I'm sorry. A day in the life, I think.
Got out
of bed. Yeah.
Across my head?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I understand why you didn't remember those lyrics, because those are lyrics you can't relate to.
Whoa. Okay, we started. All right. This should be Friday when we do that, but it's a Thursday. We'll start that. Good morning, Jen.
Good morning, Handel.
There's a lovely Wayne. Good morning. Yeah, it's the big kid. And Alex is back after a couple of days being out. Hey, Alex, are you feeling better?
Yeah.
Good. And you're off tomorrow, too.
Yeah, by Wednesday.
Yeah, just a scheduled day off. See, if you had left today, or if you had not come in today, you would have, a six-day week?
I need to plot my illnesses much better.
Yeah, you surely should. And Tyler, good morning.
Good morning, Bill.
There you go. I want to make a point. Yesterday, Jen gave me a lovely group of Christmas presents. I mean, just right on. I should actually take a picture of them, which I think I will tonight and put them up. And I want to make a point to the rest of you. Jen is the only one to give me a present, you bastard! All the rest of you totally ignored me for Christmas.
Yeah,
it's true. I do hate presents. Jennifer, why did you give me that present? You know I hate them.
That's why I gave them to you.
Okay. Also, what I may do is issue a statement right now. In lieu of presents, please donate to Save the Whales. And the reason I say that is I hate the whales. So that would make me feel horrible, which is the entire point of a holiday, is it not? To make the person who receives the gift feel horrible? The book way.
Well, that's why I did it. For him. Everybody else, to make them feel good.
Yeah. Well, anyway, there were, the thinking that went into those gifts, I must tell you, was pretty spectacular.
Thank you.
Yeah. For the rest of you who are not going to give me gifts, or if you plan, do not, thank you. You are so welcome. Anytime. Thank you so much. I so greatly appreciate that. All right. It's cold today. Got some stuff going on. The president was in Kentucky yesterday. We have some water news. Johnson & Johnson vaccine may be really limited. And we'll talk about that a little later on. In the meantime, let's start it, guys. And it's time for Handle on the News. Jennifer Jones Lee, Wayne Resnick, and me, Lee Story. And it is about the president. Yesterday in Dawson Springs, Kentucky, one of the two towns that were literally wiped out, the other one being Mayfield. And I describe this as akin to Hiroshima or Nagasaki. That's what it looked like. The entire town flattened. I mean, flattened. Nothing left for the president. Pledges the federal government will do whatever it takes to assist tornado victims for as long as it takes to recover and rebuild. Here's the problem. The federal government is pretty limited in what it can do. I mean, it can issue an emergency declaration which allows FEMA to come in and do what FEMA does. And the rest of it, I guess the government could provide emergency funding. I don't know if it's grants or low-interest loans. That may be limited by law. So the states have a lot more power. Cities have a lot more power. Cities can borrow like crazy. Can go to the banks. And what bank is going to say no to a very low-interest loan over a very long time to rebuild a town? I mean, the PR would be horrific. Jennifer, have you talked to Scott about what was going on in the Midwest?
He doesn't, that's not his region. So he really doesn't have much to do with it.
Don't they do buzz? Don't they, call each other up and say, hey, look what happened here? Don't they do that?
No, they don't do that.
I would have thought they would.
They're so separate. Each region literally is kind of its own world, and they are completely separate from each other. I'm sure if they needed resources from one region to the other, they can tap each other, but no, they, it, really, they are super separate.
So if I were to call them from Kentucky, from here, hey, you're just SOL, aren't you? Have a good day.
You know him well. By the way, so one of the things I know that the president did yesterday was he increased from 75% to 100%. Would pick up the cost of all the debris removal in the area.
And can they do that? I guess through, maybe through the Corps of Engineers?
Well, I think that those are the FEMA contracts, if I remember right. I think that, don't quote me on this though, but I think FEMA handles those kinds of contracts or they figure that out kind of thing. And then also he said that they would pick up the housing for the storm victims for the first 30 days.
Now, what's the Red Cross doing in this at this point?
They also are on the ground and know they're doing one of those, like, you know, donate to the Red Cross kind
of
thing.
Yeah, of course they do. It's not a disaster. But they come out. I mean, they do what they do, the Red Cross.
And I know if you go to, I think it's Kentucky.gov, there is a specific fund that the state has set up for those victims of this. Like the Western Kentucky Tornado Fund or something like that. And that money is all going to go directly to the victims. But they're bringing in tons of bottled water because water's been an issue. Jim Ryan, I talked to him earlier. He said that he saw a big tanker truck come in with water in it for people. And they've still got, though, a lot of people without power. And the power company, it's not really a matter of rebuilding as much as it is starting over.
Yeah.
To go with.
Hey, real quick question. I don't know if you know this. The Red Cross and FEMA, do they work in as a partnership?
I have no idea.
Okay.
I don't know that one. Sorry.
Thank you so much for your information. If you would ask Scott that question, I'm just curious if there's a contractual relationship between the two.
Yeah, I'll send him a text.
Yeah.
There's this weird sheen that's been reported off the Boca Chica State Beach. Some people have described it as tar. It's 30 yards by 30 yards, so the Coast Guard and some state officials are going to take a boat out there and fly over it this morning and see if they can figure out exactly what it is.
I'll tell you what it is, it's shampoo. What? Oh, jeez Louise. All right, maybe I'm wrong.
I get your joke.
That was a joke?
Well, I think I get what you were doing.
Okay, so they're going to find out. They can't connect it. First of all, they don't even know it's oil, although it probably is. How could it be anything else?
Well, some marine safety officials said it smelled like oil.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, it was a duck.
So then the question is it part of a pipeline that is dormant there that is not flowing, or is it simply a natural burst of oil from the bottom of the ocean, which happens all the time? Maybe not to that size, but why not? You know, oil comes bubbling up. You know, as just simply naturally from beneath the ocean floor.
Yeah, I'm sure it won't be that hard to figure out what it is when daylight comes. They were trying to look at it with a helicopter, but it was nighttime.
Yeah, if you see people watching their hair, you know exactly where it is.
Oh, yeah.
We'll be back. We're taking a break. This is KFI. Jennifer, your turn.
Well, the Environmental Protection Agency is taking some steps to try to tighten the rules allowable for levels of lead in the drinking water. The Biden administration says it would like to replace all of the nation's lead service lines using new funds from the bipartisan infrastructure bill. 5 kids in Australia have died in a bouncy house that was carried away by strong winds. Looks like 4 others are in critical condition after that. And the nation's seen a pretty good jump in COVID cases this week. Health officials now warn the Omicron cases are doubling every 2 days in the U.S. You got your drive on the 60 with BKFI in the sky next.
All right, New Year's is coming up, which means resolutions, of course, and so you have to resolve to change things in your life. They love it here. They love being in your house. They love eating your house. Because Southern California is termite central. So what do? Well, if you know you have termites, bugs flying around, and little wood shavings at your baseboard, that's easy. You make the call to the Pacific Coast termite. But if you don't know you have termites, or even think, guys, probably don't. Doesn't matter. Call Pacific Coast Termite for a free inspection. Certain restrictions apply. They're going to come out and tell you, you have termites? Yeah, but let's catch them early days. You don't have termites? Great news.
And when they do treat your house to kill the little buggers, they do it without tenting, and that is so important. I tented before. You do not want to go there. Double bagging your food, hotel room, Pacific Coast Termite doesn't do any of that. You can even be home when they do their work. Call 800-PACIFIC, 800-PACIFIC, PacificCoastTermite.com, 800-PACIFIC.
Pacific Coast Termite, kill termite.
The clean, friendly way.
As you prepare for the holidays, don't let rising prices get you down. Visit your local grocery outlet and make the most of your budget. Frito-Lay party-sized chips are buy two, get one free. That's $2.86 each when you buy three.
Check out weather from KFI. We've got a mostly cloudy day ahead. Tiny chance of showers. Highs will just be in the upper 50s to low 60s. This report is brought to you by Grocery Outlet. We're watching your drive on the 60.
As you make way through the Diamond Bar area, eastbound side past Diamond Bar Boulevard before Soul Branch Road or Chino Hills Parkway, got a crash in middle lanes, and that's going to be a rough ride for you to come away from Grand, also affecting your drive 57 northbound from as far back as Pathfinder.
Oh,
and now, eastbound side of the 10 before Via Verde, still dealing with a wreck in middle lanes. That's going to be heavy for your drive as you come away from Grand as well. Riverside 215 north at Martin Luther King Boulevard, that's an early right clear to the right shoulder, although still a rough go for your driver as you come out of the Marina Valley area from Alessandro. And looks like there's police activity for you on the westbound side of the 210 at Pepper in the Rialto area. Police activity has the right lane taken away. KFI in the sky helps get you there faster. I'm Nick Pagliocchini.
This report is sponsored by Norm Reeves Honda Superstore. Norm Reeves Honda Superstore has your roadmap for a super holiday upgrade during Happy Honda Days. Return your Honda lease or swap your old ride for a brand new Honda. And with more vehicles arriving for the holidays, choose from a super selection online at normreeves.com.
Still loving those solar max panels.
Darn tootin' I am. I save tons of money, and the panels are going to keep the lights on all through the fall and winter months. And because Solar Max does everything under one roof here in Southern California, I get the best service.
And right now, Solar Max has an exciting new offer. You get Tesla 420 panels and power walls for $79.96 per month and zero down.
Dial #250 for your cell phone. Say the keyword Solar Max. #250 Solar Max, or go to solarmaxtech.com. Monthly payment available on approved credit. See SLB number 97304.
As parents, we've done everything we can to keep our kids safe, happy, and healthy during this pandemic. From finding the best face masks, to making sure their hands are clean. And now we have the best tool to help keep them even safer. The most important thing we can do is vaccinate our kids to protect them against COVID-19. Vaccines have been proven safe and effective for children 5 and up. Talk to your child's doctor or visit myturn.ca.gov to find a vaccine near you. Brought to you by the California Department of Public Health.
The new normal means protecting yourself and others by getting a COVID test before and after travel and when you may have been exposed. Even if you're vaccinated, you can still contract COVID, especially during these holiday and winter seasons. COVIDclinic.org offers rapid testing at locations throughout SoCal, with results usually within an hour. No-cost-to-patient testing also available throughout all SoCal locations. Visit COVIDclinic.org to book an appointment near you. COVIDclinic.org.
The holidays are doubly important this year, so make your celebrations doubly special. At Ralph's, we've got a huge selection of high-quality meats on top of fresh, natural produce, like fresh, never-frozen prime-grade beef and our Citrus Trees organic Brussels sprouts, or delicious king crab legs with our private selection of our baked potatoes. Oh, I say that doubly fast. Ralph's, fresh for everyone.
For sizzling savings, pick home a bone-in ribeye roast. They're just $6.99 a pound. Limit one with your card, an additional $25 purchase. Ralph's. Fresh from everyone.
Living with someone who tested positive for COVID-19 in the past 5 days, those 18 and over who are not vaccinated may be able to take part in a clinical trial or possible medication to prevent COVID-19. Participants will receive study-related care at no cost. To learn more, visit COVIDMoveAhead.com.
Sponsored by Merck. When you have sinus throat congestion, you need a medicine that's effective and long-lasting. Mucinex VM's bilayer tablet allows for immediate and extended release, relieving both wet and dry coughs and weakening chest congestion for 12 long hours. Grab Mucinex VM, available at Walgreens.
In 2007, Marine First Lieutenant Travis Manion was killed in Iraq after saving his wounded teammate. Travis's legacy lives on through the words he spoke before his final deployment. If not me, then who? Words that today fuel the spirit of Travis Manion Foundation. And through TMF, these words can live in you too. Show the world what you're made of, because character is invisible until it's not. Find out how you can strengthen the character of your community alongside empowered veterans families of the fallen and inspire civilians at TravisMania.org.
Yeah, yeah.
Have you heard the ads from the other mortgage companies talking about their great rates, but they never mention the rate? It's because their rates really aren't that great. At Interactive Mortgage, our 15-year fix is a rock-bottom 1.99% rate in APR. That's right, 1.99% with no points. And Interactive Mortgage will even pay your title, escrow, and appraisal fees. Shorten your loan term, cash out for the holidays, or simply lock in a rock-bottom rate before rates go up. Give yourself the gift that keeps on giving this season. Call Interactive Mortgage today at 844-371-CASH. That's 844-371-CASH. 844-371-2274. Or visit InteractiveMortgage.com.
Windpoint Corporation, DBA Interactive Mortgage. Equal housing lender. Terms and conditions apply. New clients only. Loan amount $300,000 to $647,200. Minimum FICO of 740 and maximum LTV of 60%. All loans subject to underwriting approval and not all applicants will qualify. Loans made or arranged pursuant to California Finance Law License Number 603F938. NMLS Number 302352.
Bonnie doesn't care if people die. I say this to his face. He doesn't care if people die. He doesn't care if people get killed by the criminals he releases.
They know what issues promote
in order to give them some kind of virtue shield.
John and Ken, weekdays at 2.
But in fact, they're as close to cold-blooded killers as you're going to find.
On KFI.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad.
It is a Thursday morning, December 16th. Good morning, everybody. Handle and the morning crew, let's return to Handle on the news. Jennifer Jones Lee, who I don't see.
There she is.
Oh, there she is. She's coming in. And Wayne and me. Amplify Energy Corp and two of its subsidiaries were indicted yesterday by the feds on a misdemeanor count of illegal discharging of oil. This is in connection with that oil leak in Huntington Beach. And the feds say there are various ways in which the company was negligent. Possibly the most interesting one. There were 8 different leak detection alarms over a 13-hour period, and responding properly to any one of them should have alerted them to the spill. They could have minimized the damage, but instead, all they did every time an alarm went off,
shut it off,
turn it back on.
Right,
but it made it worse. Well, here's their defense, is that we did shut it off every time, and then we found there wasn't a problem. It was dark. There was one report or a minimal number of reports. People on the rig checked it out, their people checked it out. Now, it's important to keep in mind that this was a grand jury indictment. And there's no defense to a grand jury indictment. You don't put up a defense. It's simply the prosecutor saying, hey, here it is, this is our argument. And the grand jury. Oh, yes, the grand jury process totally one-sided.
Yeah, so, you know, there's no ability for them to say, well, let me explain what happened. In front of a jury, it's a very different animal because the jury does listen to both sides. So this is not a guarantee.
It's a misdemeanor and it's corporation.
Yeah.
So nobody's going to jail.
Right.
And even as a misdemeanor, the fines can't be that massive.
Right. And they, but are they going to, yeah, I think they're going to defend or they're going to settle.
For
a $2,000 fine or whatever the hell it is. But it could be substantial.
All right, there was a statement from the mayor of Manhattan Beach yesterday that says that the city is going to limit outdoor dining, and it was because of things like the impact on street cleanliness, traffic, safety, and noise. Well, a bunch of businesses now are saying, whoa, 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 please don't limit our outdoor dining because we have people who don't want to dine inside yet. They still like to be outside where they feel that it's ventilated. Also, you've got the Omicron variant coming. People are a little hesitant even to go back into restaurants. The last thing they might want to do is dine inside. Now is not the time to limit our outdoor dining.
Yeah, hey, now I'm a little confused because according to Manhattan Beach, outdoor dining on sidewalks, patios, public right-of-ways is not affected. It's only decks.
These special things they brought,
they built.
Spaces and built them there. Those are what they're taking.
Yeah.
Wow. COVID outbreak at a school in Orange County. An entire sixth grade class is in quarantine learning by Zoom this week. Dozens of cases, according to the Placentia Yorba Linda Unified School District. That's an Travis-ranked school. So they're trying to figure out how did so many of these kids get COVID?
Yeah, and
far more than any other school.
Yes, far. Wait a minute. I mean, this, you don't usually see this kind of thing.
Well, COVID and the Rams, it's just getting worse. We've got three more players going onto the reserve list, and the team is trying to prepare for this game against the Seahawks on Sunday. And to be activated from a COVID list now, so once you're on it, you test positive, you must have two negative tests within a 24-hour period. And the Rams, who are active, were unable to get on the practice field Tuesday or Wednesday because their facility in Thousand Oaks is shut down under the NFL's protocols for teams with COVID-19 cases. The ones who even were not COVID or on the protocol couldn't even practice because they're everybody who was.
Whether they have COVID or were in contact with someone with COVID, you know, if you were the opposite team, wouldn't you just send someone on COVID into the practice? You know, like a Trojan war. But then wouldn't your team also have
No,
because you hire someone from the outside.
Oh, a third party.
Yes.
Pretty easy.
It's like the blanket with smallpox that were given to the Indians. One of the better stories, one of the better historical stories about the United States and the way the government treated the Indians. Well, I think that would work. You know, that would decimate the team. That's what I would do. But then again, that's one of the reasons I'm not a coach.
So you may recall the case of two women who were dropped off at separate hospitals and died. And, of course, nobody knew who brought them there or what happened. Foul play was suspected. And now some arrests have been made. But what's interesting is it seems that the source of this information that arrests have been made coming from the husband of one of the victims. I haven't seen an official police announcement. Have you, Jenny?
No, I have not.
So this is the husband of Christy Dyer,
right,
who was a model and was one of these two women who were now... They think they ended up at somebody's house or apartment and were drugged against their will or without their knowledge, and it went bad, and then the bad people just dumped them in front of the hospital. So maybe the police will be saying something today.
This is the story I saw as well.
But February, we'll come back. More handle on the news. This is KFI, Jennifer Jones Lee.
Los Angeles police captain has sued the city because he was demoted after he criticized fellow officers for firing beanbag shotguns at protesters. He said he was punished because he said the weapons were wrongfully used against people who gathered to demonstrate against the murder of George Floyd in 2020. News is brought to you by Pure Gun Water. Three teams have been arrested in connection with several armed robberies in Southeast LA County. Okay. Detectives investigating robberies in Norwalk and Industry this week got a car description and plate number and gave out an alert. The car was later spotted by a deputy from Lakewood Station. Cops say they found more than $1,000 in evidence linking teams to multiple robberies. Detectives say the three may also be to blame for armed robberies at gas stations and convenience stores in Bellflower, Pico Rivera, Whittier, and Downey. A big rig driver in Colorado has been sentenced to more than 100 years in prison for a highway pileup that killed four people and injured six others. Investigators say the driver was doing at least 85 miles an hour in 2019 in an area where trucks are supposed to go 45. A man in Monrovia is trying to keep what he thinks is a pregnant bear from giving birth underneath his home.
Two bears that hang around Jerry Shutman's yard have recently been going under his house through his crawl space.
This is a pair of bears that have been coming around all year.
Shutman says the bears have been using grass and plants from his yard to build what he thinks is a nest for a mama bear to give birth. He says he tried putting a cover over his crawl space to keep them out, but they tore it off.
I'm going to put a new cover over the crawl space once I know the bears are out of there. And bolt it down so that they can't lift it up.
Shutman says the bears have torn up some of his installations, like trolley KFI News.
Nearly 100 conservative lawmakers in the UK have opposed the Prime Minister's new COVID-19 restrictions, even as cases in Britain have topped 78,000. The measures still passed, but one lawmaker said the vote yesterday was a very clear message that colleagues are not happy with how the government is operating. Prime Minister Boris Johnson's approval ratings have fallen, and many conservatives say they've lost faith in his response to the pandemic. With the rise of the Omicron COVID cases in New York, shows like Broadway's Hamilton will temporarily go dark.
Which is a Tina Turner jukebox musical, canceled two of its performances. Also, Harry Potter, the Cursed Child, canceled its performance, as well. Also, Mrs. Doubtfire, canceled.
ABC's Tom Tudorini says that in each case, at least one member of the show cast or crew tested positive for COVID. And the first phase of restoration work has been finished on part of LA's first UNESCO World Heritage site, the Hollyhock House. In the Hollywood area, was designed by famous architect Frank Lloyd Wright. It was built between 1919 and 1921. Work now being done on his guest house. It's slow on the 405.
As you make your way out of the Mission Hills and North Hills area, from as far back as Devonshire, you're going to really feel the pinch. As you continue through the San Fernando Valley into the Fulton Pass, looks like not too far from Mulholland to Skirball, 405 southbound. You've got an early problem in clear with the right shoulder. Also, getting reports of a possible problem on the northbound side of the 405. Not too far from Mulholland to Skirball, so if you have an update on this or anything else going down the drive, time 250 on your cell phone, keyword KFI traffic. Well, before all of that, northbound side of the 405, still going clear out of the south bay. If you use Carson from before the 110, that will be packed in pretty tight for the straight on through the West LA and the 10. Checking in on your drive in Orange County, 5 northbound at 3.0 Park, leading the 91. That will be heading into La Mirada toward Valley View. Southbound 75, seeing some passing doors going up to Anaheim as you come away from about La Palma Avenue. That will be heading toward Disneyland Drive. KFI in the sky helps get to there faster. I'm Nick Collier, senior.
The Seattle Kraken and Dirt are smacking at Honda Center. It's the Pacific Division leading Anaheim Ducks dominating to win by a score of 4-1. The Kings are at the Florida Panthers today at 4. You can hear that match live through the iHeart Radio app. And the Chargers have a Thursday night date with the Kansas City Chiefs at SoFi Stadium. Kickoff set for 5:15 live on Alt 98.7 FM. I'm Wayne Resnick, KFI Sports.
I am one of thousands of women with metastatic breast cancer, or MBC, which is breast cancer that has spread to other parts of the body. I am living in the north and taking Ibrance calcifexor. Ibrance 125 milligram tablet with an aromatase inhibitor is for postmenopausal women or for men with HR-positive, HER2-negative MBC as the first hormonal-based therapy. Be in your room. Ask your doctor about Ibrance and visit Ibrance.com. Ibrance can cause low blood breast cancer that may lead to serious infection. Ibrance can cause severe inflammation of the lungs. Ibrance can lead to death. Tell your doctor right away if you have no or worsening symptoms, including trouble breathing, shortness of breath, cough, or chest pain. Before taking Ibrance, tell your doctor if you have fever, chills, or other signs of infection, liver or kidney problems, are or plan to become pregnant, or are breastfeeding. Common side effects include low red blood cell and low platelet count, infections, tiredness, nausea, or mild abnormalities in liver blood tests, diarrhea, hair thinning and loss, vomiting, rash, and loss of appetite.
SoCal weather from KFI, mostly cloudy with a 20% chance of rain this afternoon. Highs will be in the mid-50s to the low 60s. We've got another chance of rain coming in the first part of next week. We leave local, live in the KFI 24-hour newsroom. I'm Jesse Jones Lee.
Hey, you missing teeth? There has never been a better solution for replacing all of your missing teeth. You're down to gums. Cutting Dental has changed the game with their new permanent teeth in a day procedure. Created in their on-site lab, they pioneered dental prosthetics like nobody else. Then again, new permanent teeth in a day, they're completely lifelike. They feel natural, they look natural, and you can bite and chew, just like you used to. No other product comes close. Technology exclusive to Cutting Dental and at a competitive price. Other products in other places are heavy, clunky, they don't do it. Say goodbye to all the dental drama. Cutting Dental. Get $1,000 off your procedure. This offer starts January 31st. Get a free exam, x-rays, and CT scan worth $1,500. They have no money down payment plans. Call 888-640-SMILE. 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 Your way through the holiday season with the LA Kings Holiday Pass. Each pass includes one ticket to 3 or 5 LA Kings home games, plus a limited edition Dream Valley Tropical Mall. To purchase, visit lakings.com/holiday pass. Holiday hosting is easy. Your special favorite from State of Brothers Market. Serve your guests a flavorful bone ribeye roast for just $6.99 a pound. Or, if you like holiday ham, Smithfield Boeing Spiral Flight Half Ham is only $1.49 a pound. Hot fresh green beans for only 99 cents a pound. And make it a merry night. 36 packs of Bud Light or 24 packs of Michelob Ultra are just $19.99 each. Stater Brothers Market, wishing you the merriest Christmas.
advanced in your hiring process? Streamline your route to hire. With Indeed, their hiring platform makes it easy to attract, screen, and interview candidates all in the same place. Find your next great hire and visit Indeed.com/credits.
For official rules and more information about contests on this station,
go to KFIAM640.com/rules.
KFI congratulates Tawala Sharp and Mo Kelly for their well-deserved recognition at the LA Press Club Southern California Journalism Awards.
Picking up not one, but two nods
for Best Personality Interview
and Radio Journalist of the F***ing Year.
You deserve it, Tawala. Just really warms my heart.
Time to expand the trophy case.
KFI, AM 640.
More stimulating talk.
Continue with Handle on the News. Jennifer Jones, Lee Wainwright, and me.
All right, I'm going to give us the nuts and bolts of this one and then let you guys go at it. So there's a judge, an appeals court judge in Manhattan that really got on prosecutors for filling out Harvey Weinstein's rape trial last year with what one judge deemed was incredibly prejudicial testimony from women whose allegations weren't part of the criminal charges against him. And this judge seems to be open to reversing Weinstein's conviction because of that.
Yeah, it had to do with bringing in witnesses who really had nothing to do with the actual crime that Weinstein was in charge of. Although, there was a hearing over that. And the prosecutors argued you want to bring in X number of witnesses. And the defense said you can't do that for exactly what the reason the judge said. And the judge ruled that those witnesses were okay in the field court. Said, what are you doing? It's so prejudicial. So insanely prejudicial. Although you can argue pattern, intent, motive. You can bring in other witnesses, but with the appeals court effectively said this judge said you went so over the top, judge, that it may very well be overturned. Same thing with Bill Cosby. Well, in that case, they didn't have to get to the point, to the question of should the judge have allowed all those women in the Bill Cosby case because the DA messed up by promising he wouldn't prosecute them. So that's the reason. It's a different set of facts. But the problem with this prior bad act evidence is that it is allowed as long as it's more probative than prejudicial. Right. But what makes it tricky is every state has different standards. Some states are stricter than others. New York is particularly strict, meaning it's more likely a judge makes a mistake when he allows other women to testify. And although that one judge was very vocal about this, all of the five-judge panels seemed to agree that the judge in the trial went too far. Right. So, very surprised if you see the conviction thrown out. Yep. And as far as they'll retry him, and just bring it out without all those witnesses. They may be able to bring in one or two. Yeah. The judge may still say, okay, we'll bring in one or two, but that is it. So speaking of criminal trials, yesterday in Minneapolis, the jury heard what we now know is called the spark of life testimony. This is the death of Dante Wright, who was shot by a police officer from Harvey. They pulled out a gun instead. And as we learned from the George Floyd trial, Minnesota is very rare amongst jurisdictions that allows family members to testify at the trial about their family member who died and how it affected them and what they were like now, to humanize them. I do not know why any state would allow this. It is so prejudicial. Because the defense can't argue. I mean, there's nothing to say.
It's a cross-examination.
But what are they going to say?
But they don't, because he wants to get into saying, did you say that your loved one was great? Oh, what about that time he kicked the dog?
Or even,
the dog?
Or even worse, the effect on the family. Look what happened. You can argue it wasn't that bad an effect. You can't argue that. So, I mean, you talk about prejudicial versus probative. This is purely prejudicial. And to get the emotions of the jury up. I don't know why any state would allow it. I don't know why it hasn't gone to Supreme Court where the Supreme Court throws this out. Now, the Supreme Court may not be able to do anything about it, and here's why. If it doesn't rise to a truly constitutional level,
they don't have jurisdiction.
Well, I think the constitutional level is there because what it does is it does give you true due process. It doesn't give you a fair jury trial, which the Fifth Amendment does. I think the court could rule on it and say, across the board, this is so prejudicial that it denies you of a fair trial. I would argue that. They haven't had a bite at it.
Yeah. All right, we talked about this a little bit yesterday. Derek Chauvin pleaded guilty to violating George Floyd's civil rights, and he had previously pleaded not guilty in this. Now he pleaded guilty in this case. You both mentioned that he probably did this so that he could go to federal prison, which is better than being in a state facility. Now, the one thing that I thought, though, that was notable was after the hearing and the Floyd family and the way they came out, and they were still so angry at him. And I think Thelonious Floyd said, we can never get justice because we can never get George back. And then another brother said, my reaction is not what you'd expect. I'm still feeling anger I felt in the beginning, and that this is what they wanted from Derek Chauvin in the beginning, not now. It felt like it was too little too late for the family.
Yeah, Thelonious Ford, or Thelonious...
Floyd.
Floyd, I'm sorry. That's a very interesting name. You argue he got that nickname because he committed so many felonies. That's just an interesting name.
Maybe I'm pronouncing it wrong.
It's not pronounced Thelonious.
Felonies, sorry.
Felonies, or actually speak Tagalog?
Let's not make fun of
them. I figured it out.
I apologize.
Let's make fun of everything. Does he do a lot of karaoke?
Oh,
I don't know.
Stop
let's,
it.
Okay, okay.
Stop it now.
Let's take a break.
Hush you.
Let's take a break. Kfi AM 640. Handle here. Let's check in with Jennifer.
Congressman Jim Jordan's being called a traitor for sending a January text saying former Vice President Pence should halt the certification of the 2020 election. The Ohio Republicans admitted to sending the text to former White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows on January 5th. The Bank of England has raised interest rates in response to surging consumer prices. It's the first central bank among the world's leading economies to do so since the pandemic started. And Tiger Woods will be in a golf tournament today, less than a year after nearly losing a leg in a serious car accident here in SoCal. Woods will be teaming up with his 12-year-old son, Charlie, in the PNC Championship. We've got your drive with VKFI in the sky next.
Refinancing your home makes a lot of sense now, and there now is kind of a timeline to deal with it. Here's why. Interest rates have not yet been affected by inflation, and boy, they will. Pretty soon, I guess. And also, you've got tons of equity in your house because of rising property values, and that does nothing. A bunch of money sitting there. Why don't you borrow against the equity? Do something with it. Invest it. Make some money. And because you're paying back the loan at very low interest rates, so that makes a lot of sense. And HMS Capital is the company I'm recommending. HMS Capital is the only lender that I know that encourages homeowners to apply with competitors at the same time. Mark Tice of HMS Capital is that company that you get to get. That's been two more years, so I know. Call 833-255-5698, 833-255-5698. Visit hmscapital.com.
Shipping express by the 21st so they get there in time for the holidays. In-store only offer ends 12/19. Visit staplesconnect.com/shipping.
SoCalWeather from KFI, mostly cloudy today with a slight chance of showers. High will just be in the mid-50s to low-60s. This report is brought to you by your Staples stores. From the Southern California Toyota Dealers Traffic Center, we make it easy. We're taking your drive on the 60.
You betcha, boy. I tell you, yesterday morning, there was a lot of talk about common spots in the warehouse. And Bernardino, this is one busy spot in Vermont. If you just see a diamond ball, let's say two white lines, it's still about 10 hours for a while now. Very complicated crash. And it affects two freeways, of course. It's the North 57 East 60 split. So that's where it's all taking place. Now, the 57 itself is back up to the 60. That's not the end of the world yet, but we're always getting pretty close. So we're going to D50, diamond bar, two right. Now, the other way around, the South 57 and West 50, they're okay. By morning, drop standard. The South 57, you can get a phone. The field side is supposed to be okay. Back to the San Fernando Valley, CHC is trying to check out some more quarantine at Woodley. That's a little bit west of 405. A little bit of sun there. South 405 out of the valley, well, predictable. Almost turning away now. It's pretty depleting anything. Once over the hill, things are a little bit better. They are flying the sky. Help get you there faster. I'm Jeff Baugh.
This report is sponsored by Farmers and Merchants Bank.
Farmers and Merchants Bank wishes you and yours a very Merry Christmas. To learn more about F&B's Christmas traditions, visit fnb.com/Christmas.
Hi, I'm Dan McKenna, McKenna BMW Norwalk and Southfield BMW Farm. You haven't driven on the radio for a while because you haven't had enough cars to sell, but that's all changing. With two BMW dealerships serving Illinois County, you have a great selection of new BMWs. In fact, if you don't see what you're looking for, it's either on its way or it's a special order and delivered to your door. The days of walking through 1,000 new BMWs are gone, but finding exactly one McKenna BMW or Southfield BMW is here to stay. Visit McKennaCars.com or stop by the dealership near you. You're going to thank me.
And you lot, the prevailing opinion is, if you don't live it, you don't believe it. The people at Uline believe in hard work, and they live it by being there 24/7 to answer your call, having 38,000 items in stock, and offering same-day shipping from 12 locations across North America. Business owners, sellers, buyers, shippers, and packers believe it. Uline is the hard-working, dependable source for your shipping and industrial supplies. Visit Uline.com.
Oh, they can't see you again.
Not many more shopping days to decide whether to buy myself. And now, the top five reasons to visit Morongo. Number five.
Get the gift of good times, and you'll find a new slot or table game around every corner at Morongo. Surprise, you've already won.
Number four.
Gift a day giveaway. You'll get gifts Monday through Friday till December 21st, when you earn 500 points on your rewards card.
Three.
Christmas Day dining deal. From Cielo to Good Times Cafe, we've got deals from the clouds to the casino floor.
And the number two.
Christmas Day freebie. Get a fancy Christmas brooch Christmas Day.
And the number one reason.
12 Days of Fabio. 60 winners in 12 days will win one of Fabio's kitchen essentials. Go to MorongoCasinoResort.com to register today.
Morongo Casino Resort and Spa. Morongo. Good time!
One Ranch Honda Superstore has one roadmap for a super holiday upgrade during Happy Honda Day. Return your Honda lease to one of our five Honda lease return super centers or swap your old ride for a brand new Honda. And with more vehicles arriving for the holidays, you'll get a super selection and a super experience. Every new One Ranch Honda is backed by our exclusive price protection guarantee. With state, if you can find a brand new Honda for less within 5 days, One Ranch will pay you the difference or buy your vehicle back. Discover the joy of the season and upgrade at One Ranch Honda Superstore during Happy Honda Day. Visit our super award-winning Long Range Honda Superstore location in Huntington Beach, West Covina, the Irvine Auto Center, and the number one Honda store in the world in the Cerritos Auto Square. Plus, we're now open in Vista. Shop online at NorRange.com.
We have a lot to celebrate this holiday season. The COVID-19 hasn't gone away, so let's make sure to keep our celebration safer by following
our
superheroes, and we're more than to protect you and others. Keep down small, short, and outdoors. If you're uncertain, everyone's back to us. We're going to see it safely this year. Find a vaccine in your room.
Yeah.